today's ASMR World are all good today. So in today's episode, we're going to start our top 100 players of 2018. Top 100 footballers of 2018, according to 442 magazine. We are joined today by Percy Penguin, who is our new channel mascot. He will be here accompanying me on every video from now on, as long as I remember to bring him along. How are you doing, Percy?
How do you?
Right, so let's start. Today we might just get through 100 to number 80, so the first 20. Let's get going anyway. So in at number 100 we have PSV's Erving Lozano, fated as a future superstar from the moment he set foot in Europe. Lozano has proven the hype correct. PSV's top scorer in his debut season, Chucky, so nicknamed because he used to jump out from underneath unsuspecting youth teams' beds back in Mexico, like the character in Child's Play, holy crap that shoot me up, was central to his new team securing the Eredivisie title. He started fast in the World Cup with Mexico too, scoring a superb counter-attacking winner to seal a famous win over holders Germany. A record-breaking start to the title defence has vindicated his decision to stay for now, but the 23-year-old's ability to create as well as score is widely admired. He has been well linked recently with Everton Football Club. Number 99 in it, the brother of Eden Hazard. This is Torgan Hazard of Borussia Mönchengladbach. Liverpool were linked to him yesterday. It'd be fair to say that 2018 was Hazard Jr.'s best year, and his reward for was playing time at the World Cup in Russia. The 25-year-old approaches the prime of his career, showing ever-continuing signs of improvement. The Belgian made a lightning start to his career with all of his skills on show. His goal-scoring output is better than most wingers, but it's his interplay and agility in tight attacking spaces which makes him so hard to stop and such a pleasure to watch. It's no surprise that many around Europe have taken notice of the player, who has now fully stepped out of brother Eden's shadow. Fair play to the lad. 98 and an ex-United player didn't really make it for us. Memphis Depay of Lyon. It's crazy to think this lad is only 24 years old. He still has like a whole career ahead of him near enough. He started 2018 as an expensive riddle. The 16 million winger was such a defensive liability that he would start Lescano's biggest games from the bench, even if his stunning February winner against PSG teased at more than a super sub role. Now, moved to the centre by coach Bruno Genesio, the Dutchman has been more productive than ever. Depay has laid on more goals and assists combined in 2018 than Neymar or Kylian Mbappe, and his switch has done Ronald Koeman a favour too. He was a key part of Holland's surprise qualification for the Nations League Final Four. 97. And we have Gabriel Jesus of Manchester City. The second half of 2018 has been frustrating for Jesus. He's been pretty poor, to be fair. He started just five of City's first 17 Premier League games, scoring only 3 times, and he has also lost his position as Brazil's first choice centre forward after a disappointing World Cup where he failed to find the net. Still, the former Palmeiras man was a key part of a magnificent Man City team which won the English title with a record 100 point haul last season, netting 13 times in the top flight, including the gorgeous win at Southampton, which lifted them to that 3-figure tally, plus another 4 in Europe. Still only 21, he remains one of the most gifted young strikers on the planet. I don't think Jesus will ever be top. I don't think he'll ever be a Neymar, Messi, an Aguero. 1996, and it is Alessio Romagnoli of AC Milan. It's not been a great year to be A, Italian, or B, play for Milan, and yet centre-back Romagnoli has managed to rise above the underachievement around him and prove himself as a captain that the Rossoneri can finally be proud of. Injury has stunted a month of his 2018-19 season, and therefore a seamless succession to Mancini's national team too. But there's little doubt that the stylish 23-year-old will form part of the Azzurri's first choice backline for years to come. Fair play, they've been after someone to succeed Chiellini and Bonucci for a long time. And there's your man. Number 95. I don't know how he's made it into the top 100. He's our first choice striker. Yeah, I don't think he gets anywhere near our team right now. Once he's back, or he's on bereavement leave at the minute. I'm not sure who passed away, I haven't looked. But he's not in great form before that. And that is Romelu Lukaku at 95. Lukaku turns 26 in May, but he's yet to shake off the inconsistency which has defined his game for several years. On his day, the Belgian is unstoppable. I agree with that. Combining intelligent movement, ruthless finishing and powerful running, while his first touch and hold-up play vary wildly from unplayable to unwatchable even in the same game. It's hard to argue with his scoring record, however. Lukaku struck 16 goals in 34 Premier League appearances last season, as well as 5 in 8 Champions League outings. He impressed with a big World Cup too, as Belgium reached the semi-finals, and he ended the calendar year with 14 goals in 14 matches for his country. Perhaps he's just at the wrong club. I don't know. He was never fantastic, like out and out goal scorer for Everton, was he? But now Mourinho's gone, maybe Solskjaer can get the best out of him. We'll have to wait and see. I don't see how he fits in with the Solskjaer way of playing now. In at number 94, and this player really impressed me at the World Cup, is Ante Rebic, the Croatian, who plays at Eintracht Frankfurt. The 25-year-old Croatian came of age in 2018, spearheading Niko Kovac's Eintracht Frankfurt attack at the Commerzbank Arena. Rebic's brace held down by Munich 3-1 in the German Cup final. If a terrific goal against Argentina and some outstanding displays at the 2018 World Cup showed Europe's biggest clubs that he's quite the dynamic talent. 5 goals in his first 8 Bundesliga games for the Eagles this season proved it definitively. United remained interested in Rebic, making Frankfurt's decision to sign him up until 2022 in August, with a reported buyout clause to warm off potential suitors all the more prescient, whatever the flipping word is. Number 93. Heard a lot about this lad, but not seen much of him. Sergei Milinkovic-Savic of Lazio. I think he's Serbian. Last season, he delivered the breakthrough season his talent has long demanded. The Serbian midfielder seemed to turn in match-winning displays each week, contributing 14 goals and 7 assists in all competitions for Simone Inzaghi's improving Lazio. Every outing raised the 23-year-old's stock. Lazio eventually finished 5th, and there was talk of a 100 million move to Real Madrid, United or Juventus after their heartbreaking final day defeat Inter in May cost the club a Champions League group stage, their first one in 11 years. But he stayed at Lazio, and who knows, eventually might move on. Number 92 is Timo Werner of RB Leipzig. The Werner hype may have cooled. No goals from free starts as your country crashes out of the World Cup group stage will do that to you. But the 22-year-old centre-forward still leads the line for RB Leipzig and the German national team, and rightly so. Domestically, Werner is still your strong. He had 10 Bundesliga goals by mid-December to kick off the new season, a haul bettered by only one other player. Unless Jogi Löw conjures a new solution, the former Stuttgart ace remains Germany's top striker to fire them towards better times. 91. Edin Dzeko of Roma. The big Bosnian has hit the best form of his career in Rome, and last season he got 8 goals in 12 European appearances. The powerful forward may have hit something of a domestic slump this season with only 2 goals thus far, but the Champions League continues to be a profitable hunting ground. He struck 5 times in Roma's group, and now defence fancies the 32-year-old's combination of muscle and technique. Now, number 90-81. In at number 90 we have Nabil Fekir of Lyon. Liverpool fans, and maybe even Fekir himself, 2018 as the year his $53 million transfer to Anfield fell through, but there were plenty of highlights for the Lyon playmaker. He produced some sparkling performances during the first half of the year, and while he wasn't part of Deschamps' preferred 11 at the World Cup, he appeared as a starter or substitute in 6 of France's 7 matches en route to the ultimate triumph. Fekir has gone a little stale during the autumn months, but you sense he'll step up his game again when the inevitable move to a bigger club finally occurs. 89. And an ex-Newcastle player, Florian Thauvin of Marseille. How the hell did they let him go down? Newcastle fans may rub their eyes in disbelief, but yes. Oh, where's that come? That is that Florian Thauvin. And yes, his place in 442's 100 list is fully deserved. He scored 22 league goals alone last season, was the only non-PSG to make the four-man Liga 1 Player of the Year shortlist. He's already into double figures for goals this season, flipping heck. Sorry. He helped Marseille reach the Europa League final and collected a World Cup winner's medal, albeit appearing on the pitch for only 2 minutes at the tournament. At 25, Thauvin has finally added focus and consistency to his considerable natural gifts. What would Benitez give for his invention and goal threat now? That's the thing, when you let players go, they can sometimes come back to haunt you. 88 is Hugo Lloris. We all know about Hugo Lloris. I think personally, his luck is getting this list. I don't think he's in the top 5 keepers in the Premier League. I think he's a bit of an accident waiting to happen. It could be what cost Tottenham potentially the Premier League this season. Above him I'd put Kepa, the keeper at Chelsea. De Gea, obviously. Alisson, Ederson, possibly Pickford. That's 5 straight away. Nick Pope, when he was hard to play. That's at 6. Even, what's his name? Potentially the Fabianski, who I think is a very good keeper for West Ham. And back when he was at Swansea, I just think Lloris has a lot of mistakes in him, unfortunately. Number 87, Giorgio Chiellini of Juventus. The Italian warhorse may be getting on a bit. He turned 34 in August, and as such isn't quite the force he once was, but nor has he lost any of the ferocity, abrasiveness or cunning that have defined his glittering career. Last month, having reversed his decision to retire from international football, he earned his 100th Azzurri cap, 14 years to the day after his debut. He is one of only 5 outfield players, along with Andrea Pirlo, Paolo Maldini, Daniele De Rossi and Fabio Cannavaro, to reach a century caps for Italy. I watched that lad against United in Turin. What a player. 86 is Blaise Matuidi of Juve. Also, a World Cup winner's medal was just reward for Matuidi, a player whose phenomenal work rate and tactical discipline have been key to the successes of his club and country over the last 12 months. In his first season with Juve, the Frenchman's box-to-box dynamism was crucial to Massimiliano Allegri's side as they conquered a 4th straight domestic league and cup double. I think it's great with Tweedy. perhaps the most underrated, eternally overlooked goalkeeper on the planet, but Navas simply hasn't played enough football to be higher on this list. Even his own club don't value him properly, despite playing a vital role in Real Madrid's string of success under Zidane. The Frenchman resisted all attempts from overlord Florentino Perez to push aside the Costa Rican, to the extent that Kepa Arrizabalaga could have been wearing royal white instead of Chelsea blue if the Bernabeu powers had their way. Navas relies heavily on his agility and feline moves across his goal mouth. It's with those that he makes life difficult for opposition forwards, and his lightning quick reflexes and reactions are extremely difficult to beat. Number 84, Thiago Alcantara of Bayern Munich. After the highs of Pep Guardiola's reign at the Allianz Arena, the 27-year-old Thiago is going through a period of introspection. Bayern's game doesn't quite relate to the midfielder's fast-paced combination game defined by staccato passing anymore. And even when it does settle into the team, injuries have struck. One second, guys. We're back. He missed the start of 2018, playing a big part role for Spain at the World Cup, then suffered ankle ligament damage just as he looked to be stepping up as a key player for new Bayern boss Niko Kovac in October. He has returned strongly, another feature of Thiago's career. His exceptional talent deserves an extended injury-free run to cement his reputation at elite level. Number 83 is Kepa, the keeper at Chelsea. This has been a dizzying year for the 24-year-old goalkeeper, who looks set for a move to Real Madrid before renewing his contract at Athletic Bilbao, which was his home club. 7 months later, Chelsea underlined just how highly rated he is by paying the full 80 million release clause to replace the departing Thibaut Courtois at Stamford Bridge. Kepa has retained his poise throughout these career about turns. He's as good as it gets with the ball at his feet, and he's fancied at home to soon wrestle Spain's number one jersey from David De Gea. I don't know, after seeing De Gea's save against Huddersfield on the weekend, I don't see how Kepa's going to get any time soon. Number 82, and that is Benjamin Mendy of Manchester City. Mendy was more prominent off the field than on it last season, as a knee injury restricted him to just 3 Premier League appearances in the first half of 2018. The Frenchman collected a World Cup winner's medal in the summer despite not playing a single minute for Les Bleus, and has been enjoying his football again at Man City until another knee injury struck in mid-November. The 24-year-old is a left-back on paper, but plays so high up the pitch that he's an auxiliary left-winger. His pace and power make him difficult to stop once he's in his stride, and there are few better at producing accurate low crosses and cutbacks from the byline, as demonstrated by his 5 assists from only 9 league games this campaign. Expect much more when he returns to fitness in February. It was a long time off, and City have just lost 2 games. I think they're missing quite a bit, along with Fernandinho. Actually, I think they've lost 3 and 5, is it? They've now lost in the league, I think so. And the last one for today's video is number 81, Arjen Robben of Bayern Munich. As he approaches his 35th birthday in January, it's hard to imagine Bayern Munich without Robben, now in his 10th and final season at the club. Imagine they must. Many believed Bavaria to be a short stopover for the Dutch winger rather than a long-term home, but player and club have been great for each other. This year hasn't been his best. Just 7 goals from 34 appearances last term, and 5 in his first 15 this. In winning his 7th Bundesliga, he surpassed Johan Cruyff's 10 domestic league titles. If you surpass him in terms of titles, it's something very special, Robin said. I'm really proud of it. He might still snare number 12 this season. With his searing pace remarkably still intact, he remains an on-pitch workaholic and a bona fide match winner while cutting inside onto his left foot, obviously. What a great early start to the list. So, we start at 100. We've just gone through the first 19. I did say we'd go through the first 20, but number 18 is on the next list. So, we'll just leave it the first 19. Or should I just do it now? We'll do it now, number 18. I'll have to try and remember that we've done it when I come back to this list in a few days' time. So, number 18. So, 100 to 80. Number 80 is Dele Alli of Tottenham, obviously. Spurs connoisseur of flair has had another year to remember. 14 goals and 17 assists across all competitions in 2017-18. A key role in England's World Cup foray and a series of eye-catching performances against the European heavyweights have all served as reminders as to just how impressive Ali is at just 22. Niggling injuries after a training summer have made for a patchy return to form since the start of the season. His absence, however, has only accentuated how important the tireless playmaker has become in a Spurs team that at times can be accused of lacking impetus in the final third. This list was done before the recent games. I mean, 5-0 against Bournemouth on the weekend, 6-2 away at Everton the week before, a couple of days before. Dele Alli playing a very important part in those games. He went off injured though, didn't he? I think that was against Everton. I'm not sure he played against Bournemouth or not, I can't remember. And you can't deny how great Dele Alli has been. He had a sticky season or two. After his first season, he went a bit quiet for a couple of seasons, but he's come back in great form since then. And that's the list done, 100 to 80. I'll be back in a couple of days' time or so with 80. Or with 80 to 60. Have a great day. Maybe 79 to 69, won't it? Or 79 to 60. There we go. Anyway.